Jesus. Praise the Lord. Amen. You may be seated for a moment. I am glad to be here another time. Praise the Lord. With us, as you all know, and let me, before I do that, let me take the time to greet Pastor and his dear wife, Alvaranga, Pastor Alvaranga and his wife. Praise the Lord. And bring you greetings from my pastor, amen, Pastor Franklin and his wife, in the name of Jesus Christ. And then to our international youth director, counselor, in the person of Minister Wint. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Minister Wint, I guess they have not heard you for a long time, so at least you couldn't come here and don't let your voice be heard. Greeting also my wife and the children. Please stand, Sister Little, so that they know you. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. And all the kids and Mother Edmund and all the children. Greet you in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ. Come on, Minister Wint, come and let them hear your voice. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Let the church say hallelujah.
Let
the church say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I don't feel bad because all of my old folks on Oakland Road know that I am green.
Amen.
So I still answer to the two names.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bless the name of the Lord.
Amen.
I just want to greet you all in the mighty name of Jesus. So glad to be here one more time.
Amen.
You know, when I was driving by myself, I would be here more often.
Yeah.
But now I can't drive by myself anymore, so I have to wait until I get a ride.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the
Lord. Elder Jackson, I still love you, my dear. Hallelujah. And I long to hear you sing. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
In Sherry, new pastor. So reach and say sweet. God lead us. Your children along where the waters flow cold, where the weary ones feel. God leads his dear children along. Some through the water, some through the flood.
Some through the fire,
but all through the blood. Some through great sorrows, but God gave a song.
In the night season, glory, hallelujah.
God bless you, Jesus.
Bless the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. And I didn't want to forget our driver, Minister Smith, who took the time from work to motor us down here. Let's give God praise for him.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
I'm tired. I'm so weary. But I must go along till the Lord comes and calls me that if you die, you won't have to perish, but you will have eternal life. Praise the Lord. And the way that he made that you must repent of your sins. Baptize in Jesus' name. Be filled with the Holy Ghost. And your parents help you to live holy and walk worthy of the vocation wherewith you are called. Praise the Lord. All right, young people. Older folks, we walk contrary. We pretty up ourselves and come to church. And we don't realize that the glory of God has left us. But because we lean on pastor's shoulder, and we think that pastor's saving grace can take you through heaven's gate, you make a sad mistake. So then, the songwriter said, my hallelujah belongs to him. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And for many years, those of us who have been coming, many of you don't even know that I was baptized in Oakland Road. And I'm still pressing on. Troublesome times, yes I have. Fall down, yes I did. But I get up and I shake myself from the dust and walking on to perfection, because I realize that there is coming a day when the glory of God shall be revealed. And I want to be there. When I looked, I didn't even get time, Pastor, because my pastor is so busy. So I don't know how he's going to manage. And when he called, this evening when he called me earlier, and I said, Pastor, what's the theme? He said, oh my God, and then he takes it to me. So I didn't get much time to go through it. But the little that I went through, let me pass it on quickly to you. And sit down, for time is going. 18 to 23, he said, I beseech thee, show me thy glory. But I'm going to skip up to verse 20. And he said, thou canst not see my face, for there shall no man see my face and live. And the Lord said, behold, there is a place by me, and thou shalt stand upon a rock. And it shall come to pass, while my glory passeth by, that I will put thee in a cleft of the rock, and will cover thee with my hands while I pass by. You can't look at the face of Almighty God in the position and condition that we are today. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. If you don't even want to hear me talk, I'm still going to talk. Because if you and I are brothers, you expect me to correct you if you're wrong. For I expect you to correct me if I am walking one ton. Lord, help me. There was a time on earth when in the book of heaven, and all the count was standing for sins yet unforgiven. Amen. Not your name. Not your name.
Amen.
My name was at the top. And many things below. But one day, one night, one evening, one afternoon, I went to the keeper and settle it long ago. Believers, settle up the account. Get the account. Pastor, don't know if a pastor not live for you. evangelist going no further than only where you are. You live by yourself, so you know how you, Lord have mercy. You did come up at Bronx 2 Sundays ago when we preached. Minister Wint, have to call me when we go home and say, boy, when you preach, no preach the Latin, they make me talk English, make me hear. For me preach a message up at Bronx 2 Sundays ago, you are living in an financial, what was it, spiritual deficit. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And you are at a dangerous position.
Yes. Holy God.
You are in a dangerous position.
Holy.
Lord, I love you. God wants you to understand that your account is not balanced.
Praise God.
Your account is unbalanced, and you know the thing that happened now. You know what happened now, Pastor. The so-called friends, them. They know say my account now in a good standing with God. And they might laugh after me. But they not say nothing. They say, look, pan the hypocrite, they go down a barn again. And when they play, and he soon to get bankrupt. Spiritually bankrupt. For we malice one another. We bite one another. We devour one another. So you can't see the glory of God. And when the glory pass through the house, there must be a shaking.
Yes.
There must be a noise.
Bless him, Jesus.
There got to be a sound.
Yes.
But if you are watching and praying, you must see the glory. Lord have mercy. Where are the mothers that used to hear that sister testify? That used to pray night and day when they were young. Five and six of them used to pray one for another. When you have a problem, we get together and we call down heaven for help. And when one get through, when you come at church a testimony night, everybody rejoice because somebody gone through. But all those put aside in the church because the glory of God has left the church. One time you used to rejoice. You used to rejoice in the Lord. You used to give God glory in spite of the problem that you might have. But you find time to prostrate on your feet, on your knees, and tell God all about it. The writer said, I must tell Jesus. But now, prideful we up. We backslide and we don't even know. We backslide and we don't even know. Because false pride full we up. Remember, you know, me no say you, me say full us up. For me not preaching to you and going like me alright. No. For me have to examine myself. You can't go on. You can't go and preach. And you can't go and talk. For after you don't know how me live. No. You don't. Me don't know about the Holy Ghost. No. You forget that we have an unseen eye. We walk through the church. And it knows everything all about you. Anywhere you sit in the church, the Holy Ghost, Lord Jesus, when you gone home and think everything all right, the Holy Ghost, with the glory of God, is spying on you.
Yes, sir.
Let the glory of the Lord be seen in you. When you walk out there, you are a carrier of the glory of God. So when you walk out there, you have to mind how you walk. You have to walk circumspect. I don't care who want to say why I'm a player, but I know that within me dwells the glory of God Almighty. And one of these days, he's coming back for a church that is prepared to meet him. Pastor, you can't carry anybody by your jacket tail if you go ahead. But if you don't preach the word, then we sorry for you. And you can't cover it up. Not even, I always say to my wife, that the Bible says the two shall be in the bed. And if anybody going is me, what a selfish man. So therefore, she has to get her act together and challenge me and say, well, honey, I am going up. We are in the great resurrection morning. But I can't know for her, for she has to know what is inside within our God and our Savior. I am, you see, when you want to go to glory, when you want to reach that point with God, you have to get selfish. You have to get selfish. Wives, you have to get up out of the bed and husband, no. I'm going to your little corner, go talk to God. Tell God about yourself. And then while you're there talking to him, you feel a little prayer wheel turning. You know that a little fire is burning. While you're having a little talk with Jesus. When my wife gone to work in the days, so I work at night. And when she gone in the days, and two little ones are sleeping, the others gone to school. And we go back into the room. And the Bible asleep on the bed with me sometimes. And sometimes it's at the table. And but when God put something in my spirit in the night, and me can't do nothing about it, me might have only shake, she might have feel the bed, I shake, I vibrate. Because sometimes God touch me, and me have to make a move. But then when she gone at the time, me back up Jesus. I say, come here, Jesus. All right, sit down right there so with me. And let us have a talk. For you said in your word that I must come to you and tell you your word. You said I must tell you all about my troubles. So right now, I have a problem that I know only you can solve. Lord God, this problem is such and such. Hallelujah to God. And when I talk to him, I say, God, are you hearing me? And sometimes I get a little hallelujah. I get a amen. Sometimes tongues come and I got to chop tongues. But then I know that God, hear me.
Amen.
And if I wait patiently, the answer will come. And when the answer come, Lord of mercy, I can't dance like the prophet when he used to dance. But sometimes I fling the foot as how I can fling them. For I say, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Hey, glory, my son. I used to watch the prophet sometimes on TV. And when I watch, especially when he have on that white suit. Oh my God. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yes, sir. What I do it, how I can do it. And give God the praise. And give God the glory. I my wife turn on this song and I hear my little 3-year-old son singing. God is Awesome. Me say, my God. Hear the people sing, God is awesome. God is awesome. Not forget it. For him 3-year-old, and him knows the God awesome.
Amen. Praise God.
So the glory of God has returned. So you got to get up. Lord of mercy, you can't sit down in the house of God and the glory come in the house. Lord Jesus, when they were pushing the thing and the chariot and the ark, my God, nobody, nor anybody couldn't touch it. But when it passed by, he said, if I pass by anything, any disease, anything, you will be blessed. You will be healed. So why you can't claim your healing and you have the glory of God in you? You got the glory. It's inside of you. For when the Holy Ghost form in you, and as long as you cherish it and you keep it clean, then anytime you feel the devil send the pain in your waist that you come, say, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, get out!
In the name of Jesus.
Some people don't put them salvation to use it up, you know, try to get that experience. Me not talk of nobody. Me talking of what God do for me. My testimony is what God did for me. Put your experience to the test. You want some money? Jesus said, all the silver and the gold is his. Yet we live like beggars. We live like beggars. And my Father have mansions. All the silver and the gold is his. So claim it now. Since the glory of God is within you, just claim it, man. Claim it. I did not know that I would have a car. And I said to my wife, I said, God, you know what happened? I must have told you the last time I came here. I said, when I go to church on Sunday, and one or two people who used to carry my wife and myself and the two boys, them used to wait until before pastor say amen, they gone through the door. They've gone through the door. Tired of me get begging ride to go home. And one day, after the last condition, and one elder said to me, little, come me carry you home. Me go home. And me say, nah, happen again. Me say, God, it not going to happen again. If not, me now go back to church. For me can't sit down and make me family after the sponge. Forget right, for go home after church.
That's right.
And if you say that I am the head, and I must be the head and not the tail. And if you say I must be a lender and not the borrower, oh, help me, Jesus. So how you allow me and the children them to go in a snow, to go home? And we ask God, and we go on fasting. Call Sister Wynn. Sister Wynn, help me to pray. Sister Wynn said, little, You know, oh God, rest you upon my mind. And God Almighty, she said to me one day, she said, God, go and bring you through anyway. She said, God, go and bring you through. Me not tell her what me want, for she help me pray for. But because sometimes you have some situation, you must have some mothers or somebody in church that you can call and say, who the glory of God shining in better than you. She said, Lord, you know what you do. Help me pray because I am getting weak. And sister, we pray with me over the phone. And she said, Nicole, God go and bring you through. Don't worry. God, when we tell her, I said, sister, we need to pray for go back home. He said, boy, shut up your mouth. Amen. And talk about you go back home. Right. When you go back home, go do.
Right.
And God, in his wisdom, sent me some money. My sister called me from Canada and said to me, little mommy dead left some money. That time I just go to Canada go bury my mother. I never even know nothing. Come back home and say, God, mommy left some money. I say, yes. How much? He didn't tell me how much. But he said, you get the papers, I send you some paper. Sign it and send it back to me. I didn't kind of doubt her. But anyway, I carry paper to pastor and make pastor sign up for me. And I send it back to Canada. And I wait a little while and that me all I say, you know what? That girl now say no money, come give me, you know. Now true sister wait. I say that girl now say no money, come give me. But if you not send it, amen. And if you send it, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And we wait and wait and wait. And one day sister will say, but brother little, what the money where your sister's visiting? We say, me no hear a thing for now. No, you're not here. All right, time ago. Until such time. And she sent me. She said, all right, the money is in the bank. I said, thank you, Jesus. And me tell my wife, she said, check the computer and check it and see what it is. And when she checked, she said, yes, so much money in the bank. I said, all right. And I said, you know what? Come, let's go look if we find something that we can drive, go to church. And we go and we find something and they start to give it trouble.